The New Covenant Family Tapes Ministry brings you a word from God. Listen, and your life will never be the same again.
Wonderful Holy Spirit, reveal Jesus afresh to everyone here today. Reveal the Great Commission afresh to everyone's heart. Reveal yourself afresh to every one of us, Lord. You are the Lord of the harvest. This year, may there be multiplications in all the churches because we know your presence. Not because of our abilities, but because we know you, Lord. Grant us the help. Just lift up your hands and glorify the name of the Lord. There's fire on the mountain here this morning. It's fire on the mountain, my friends. Everyone is changing his garment. That's what I'm hearing from the Holy Spirit. You are not living the same way you came. A new mantle of leadership is coming upon you. A new glory, a new mantle of fire is coming upon you. Your garment of righteousness is blazing white, said the Lord. This is a new era, said the Lord. We have entered a new season, said the Lord. This is a time for manifestation. Your season to show forth has come. Your season to show forth has come. You have had your seasons of training. You have had your seasons of incubation. This is your season to manifest. First, said the Lord. Why are people not winning souls? Satan's greatest weapon against the church is ignorance. And we can be ignorant of many things. But the greatest area of ignorance that has worked for him against God's army is ignorance of righteousness. The greatest weapon Satan uses is guilt, condemnation, accusations. That's the only thing he's doing every time, to accuse a believer. See what he did. God knew that. What he did to Job in the Old Testament, what he did to a number of other people. Zechariah the high priest, Satan stood at his right hand to accuse him. Moses the servant of God, Satan stood at his right hand to accuse him. Who has he not accused? God now raised for us an advocate and gave him a place at the right hand of God and say, your job is to defend the saints. Their job is to be advocating for you on earth. Your job is to be advocating for them in heaven. Your job on earth is to make sure you are speaking about Christ everywhere. Don't worry about your defense in heaven. He said, as long as you defend me before men, I will take care of your problem before God. As long as on earth, take care of opening me to men, I will take care of all the problems you have at the throne, with the angels, with God. Who has he not accused? Who? Bible says, if we say we have not sinned, we are lying. There is nobody without clay feet. It is the robe of righteousness that Jesus wears that he has used to cover you. So Satan points a finger. God say, where is he? He said, but I can't see it. But I know it happened. He said, show it now. Somebody covered it. Catherine Kuma, after being with somebody's husband and all the 8 years, he came out to start preaching. Some people said, sue that woman, adulterous woman. He said, the woman you're talking about died 1,000 years ago. This is not the Catherine Kuma. This one is the righteousness of God in Christ. How will you have confidence to face your city? Even the same place where you committed the offense, you go back there. He said, the one you are talking about is dead. If anyone be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. All things. Romans chapter 8. As I read it for you in Living Bible, I'll be looking at it in whatever translation you have. Verse 31. What then shall we say in response to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his only son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any accusation or charge against those whom God has chosen? Is one scripture Idahosa used to deal with the enemy. He said, hey, you've been challenging all the wizards in Benin, now it's our turn. The guy lifted it and said, Satan, when God justified, nobody can accuse. The case you are talking about has been thrown out of court. Even if you go there, you cannot be entertained. The judge will tell you this file is closed. So you can murmur and complain, but the case is still closed. I won't stop you from murmuring. And that devil jumped out of the window in annoyance. You know those who lose case in court, they can come and grant interview to the news. I don't agree. That judge was, that's not the point. God is a righteous judge. For slaying his son who didn't do anything, what are you expecting? That he might be just and the justifier of them that believe in Christ. That's why he killed a just man, so that the devil won't say it's unfair. Devil, you are the one who killed him, so why are you not crying foul? That's why all the people that are ungodly, that are supposed to be condemned, and justifying them. is an exchange. By one man's sin, everybody got messed up. By one man's righteousness, everybody got fixed up. Can I hear somebody say amen?
Amen.
Let's read a little more. So those who are going to hell are going because they don't know the truth. That's why the gospel must be preached. But see, the man who didn't spare his son, gave him for us. You will see the hand of God come into those areas you have been struggling, and you will see grace aiding you in your career. Success is skill plus grace. It's not just a product of hard work. Hard work plus grace. But grace doesn't mean you don't work. But after you work, something more than man is giving you the necessary ingredients to succeed. Who will bring any charge or accusation against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies them. Who is he that condemns? Jesus Christ, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble, hardship, persecution, famine, nakedness, danger, sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all along. We are considered as sheep be led to slaughter. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor demons, nor things present, nor things to come or future, nor powers, neither height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus. Good news. Oh, glory. In view of all these things, what shall we say? If God is for us, who can be against us? Certainly, God cannot be against us. For he did not keep back his own son, but offered him for us all. He gave us his son. Will he not also freely give us all things? Who will accuse God's chosen people? God himself has declared them not guilty. Who then will condemn them? Not Christ Jesus. For he is one who died. Rather, he was raised to life and is at the right hand side hand of God, pleading with him on our behalf. Who then can separate us from the love of Christ? Can trouble do it? Or hardship? Or persecution? Or hunger? Or poverty? Or danger? Or death? No, in all these things we have complete victory through him who loves us. For I am certain that nothing can separate us from his love. Neither death nor life, neither angels nor other heavenly rulers or powers, neither present nor future, neither the world above nor the world under. There is nothing in all creation that will ever be able to separate us from the love of God, which is ours through Christ our Lord. One of the reasons people are not winning souls, it affected me till I got the cure, is because they think they don't have the ability to convince other people. They think that they cannot do it. Some think that they cannot speak. Others think they are shy. Others think they don't know enough Bible. We have a lot of shortcomings. This is not saying now. Inabilities. Lack of talents in such areas. I don't have the gift of public speaking. Lack of certain abilities. Lack of skill in certain areas. Listen to me. When it comes to soul winning, God doesn't need your ability. What he needs is your availability. God does not call the equipped. He equips the called. God does not look for ability. He gives ability to the one who makes himself available. Ability to win people is why the Holy Spirit came. The Bible says, you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. You shall receive ability. You can't speak. Get ready, because there is an anointing that touches your tongue. You are shy, get ready, because when that power comes on you, it puts boldness. You are timid, get ready. The fiercest warriors in the kingdom, some of them were timid people in the past. That's why Peter said, it was not by our righteousness or by our power or ability that we got this man walking. He was talking about two things that were not man humanly. Righteousness is the ability to stand before God without a sense of guilt, a sense of condemnation or inferiority. You stand before God, you are not intimidated. I have my little kids in my house. They are not intimidated by my presence. Righteousness is a right standing that gives you boldness in the sight of God. And when you can be bold before God, who is the devil? When you turn to his direction. ability to stand before God, the holy God, without a sense of inferiority, without a sense of complex, without a sense of condemnation, without a sense of guilt. Why? Christ has become my righteousness. Then Peter said, not by our power. How come he got a crippled man healed and you are saying it's not by your power? Peter knew that there is something a believer who is baptized with the Holy Spirit has. You may not be using it, but you have it. You may be going to fast looking for power, but you already have the power. So God understood that. Instead of giving us power in levels, what he did is, let the power himself, the generator himself, come and live inside you. Listen, he said, after he has lived, he's inside you, he's resident. Stop praying for power. The power is inside. What you should do for now is activate the power. He said, he that prays in an unknown tongue activates the volcano he's already carrying. Two different things. Holy Ghost, power, fire, come on me. That is for somebody who has not received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Send down the power, we pray thee, O Lord. Send down the power. What is the other one? We say, amen. As long as you are going in that direction, you will never use what you have. This is how the devil disarmed the church. He turned the people who have a gun that is loaded and told them, you don't have what you need to shoot a bird. What the man we're shooting is a defeated foe, and yet we are armed as if he is not defeated. Then he tells us, the animal you are about to shoot is already dead. Well, he tells you, you don't have a gun. Then you look at the one you are carrying, say, what is this? He says, it's a stick. What is the game? Don't let him use it on me. If he shoots, I'm finished. He said, oh, so this is stick that the Lord gave us. Yes. He said, you need to go back to the upper room and cry for power. That's why even some ministers are going to occult world looking for power, when the church is the powerhouse of God on earth. All we need to do is pray. And you know what you do in your house? There are different ways they turn the gen on. Some is automatic, they switch off. They partake like the gen turns on. Some, you take something, you whine it. You will be praying that it will catch the first time. Hey, let this thing catch. Then it catches. The moment it catches, it is not that dormant thing lying in the gen house. If you put your hands in the wire, it knocks you off. After we have had light and we don't need it, you switch it on. It is there waiting for whenever you need it. That's what God said you will receive. The Greek word they use there is dunamis. That dunamis means two things. One, it is a power that is rechargeable. That is, it is will be there, but it's not doing anything. Whenever you need it, turn it on and it will deliver. Dunamis, the first word they use there is dynamo. It's a rechargeable power. It's like a gem. There's another type. They draw it with rope. So you go to prayer, you start praying, Father, I thank you this morning. Thank you for a good night rest. It looks like the thing is not catching. Just don't stop. Oh, I give you praise. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. My soul shall make his boast in the Lord. My your name is worthy to be praised. And somewhere, boom, it peaks. The moment it peaks, hey, it's in your spirit. It's not outside you. It's inside you. Jesus gave us a power station. He calls it cloven tongues as of fire resting on each of them. Let me tell you what cloven means. It means divided, separate. Apart from corporate anointing, what he did, he took the thing, separated it. Fire came as a ball. He separated it, dropped each person's own on his own head. Every house a generator. Every house is a generator. Don't depend on another person. Have your own power station. Don't say NEPA took light. NEPA cannot take your light, because you have a dynamic ability working on the inside of you. He said, unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above what we can think or ask. How? Through the power that is at work in us. To him be glory in the church. So the devil turned the church to go about looking for power. How many of you want special anointing? The one that is given, where did he get it? Holy Ghost. Which one do you have inside you? Holy Ghost. What is your problem? To defeat Adam and Eve, God told them, you were made in the image of God and you are made in my likeness. Satan said, you are not. You are not yet like God. But if you want to be like God, eat that tree. He first destroyed what God told them about themselves and told them to be looking for what they have. And then in order to look for what they had, he told them look for it in the tree of death and evil, so he could kill them. Have you studied how God used men in the Bible? When he met Moses, he said, what is this thing you have in your hand? Moses said, wood. He said, that wood, with it, go back to Egypt. You shall do signs and wonder. What God does is to help you discover what you already have and to show you the ability that is in it. So he told Moses, test it, throw it on the ground. He turned to something. Moses said, you mean this thing has been here and I didn't know? When he met Gideon, Gideon said, see what the enemy is doing. He said, Gideon, you are a mighty man of valor. Gideon said, Who are you talking about, Lord? He said, I'm talking about you. He said, we are only one here. Is there any other person? He said, I'm talking about you. He said, Lord, you don't know what you are talking about. My father is the least, I'm poor, everything. He said, no, you are the deliverer. He said, Finally, he said, go in this thy mind. Gideon said, Lord, I thought you would give me something. He said, you already have it. He said, go in this thy mind. You will deliver Israel. My friend, I want to let you know something. Billy Graham entered the Guinness Book of Record for pulling the largest crowd under the sun since Adam, that is in his time, and didn't have the experience of speaking in tongues. I actually believe he had it. It's just that he didn't have enough knowledge to express it. But he expressed it in the area of evangelism. Because after all, that power is not power to kabash. It is power to witness. He brought 1 million people together in Madison Square. Bonke has brought 6 million. Adeboye has brought more than that. Start trusting your divine ability. And stop crying for inabilities. The secret is, you don't have to know about gifts. You don't have to know about different gifts of the Holy Spirit. All you have to know is the Holy Spirit. I don't have to know about generator, the different current. All I have to know is how to turn on the gen. The gen does the job. The current comes from the gen. The anointing comes from the Holy Spirit. It's safer if you know the person than to know his power. Because when you know the person, you are always safe. If you feel depleted of power, you call on his name and talk to him. A fresh force will hit your soul. You don't have to be talented to be a soul winner. You don't have to be educated to be a soul winner. Apostle Atanda didn't go to school, yet he has won more souls than all the so-called Christian professors. When he lands on crusades, you see hundreds of thousands of people. Cripples will start rising up. Wheelchairs will start rising. Blind eyes will start opening. Professors will come there, get healed, get converted. All kinds of people will come there because there is something called supernatural ability that comes with the Holy Spirit. If you can even just know that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever, that if he is alive truly, then he can do today what he did yesterday. And today is even better because he's no more limited by time and space. That all your job is to introduce him to people. After you have introduced him, you can tell him, Lord, I've introduced you. Confirm your word. Back it up with evidence for the sake of these people. So you don't have to have special gift of healing. You can be healing the sick more than those who have the gift. It's not having the gift. It is using the gift that brings results. If I tell you some hard truth now, some of you will be surprised. Some of you have more gift than Benihin, but the man has more use than you. And the scripture says, the one that has and is using it, to him more shall be given. The one that has and is not using it, the little he has will be taken and given to another person who is using. Start at the level where you are. You notice that you keep increasing in the things of the Spirit as you are moving. Why? Because you are using. The law of use is the law of increase. The law of abuse is the law of decrease. Don't pray for power. Pray for utterance. That's what the Bible says. But if you are not baptized in the Holy Spirit, you need to ask for Holy Spirit baptism. And one of the fastest ways to find a believer that already knows that to minister to you. My friend, when we are looking for Holy Spirit baptism, we didn't understand the thing. So if you pray, people were speaking in tongues and we were there looking at everybody. So I would say, oh God, what did we do to you that you don't want to give us this thing? You know, the person that got me filled with Holy Spirit, one young guy, he's not that hard. He's just ignorant. The problem is, when the thing comes, you have to open your mouth and speak. It is not the Holy Spirit that does the speaking. For example, it won't be the Holy Spirit doing the evangelism. You will do the evangelism, but he will be giving you the utterance of what to say. At the end of the day, you realize you are not the one who says those things. But if you will open your mouth and talk, you will end up hearing what the Holy Spirit too is saying. It doesn't force anybody's mouth open. Even prophecy, you can be given a prophecy and you keep it for 5 years and not say it. I said, is that the truth? He showed me Acts 2. He said, And they began to speak. And he stopped. He said, who began to speak? I said, Holy Ghost. He said, no, that's not what he said. Because if it is Holy Ghost, that means there are many Holy Ghosts. Because he said there. That means the Holy Ghosts are so many. Holy Ghost Friday, Holy Ghost Junior, Holy Ghost Senior, Holy Ghost Father, Holy Ghost Wife, Holy Ghost Mother, Holy Ghost, you know, they are all talking. He said, they began, the people are speaking. Then he read the complaint. He said, they began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. He said, what the Spirit gives is utterance. The man does the speaking. So once I lay hands on you, open your mouth and start talking. This guy just touched my head. I open my mouth. My God, this gusher from the inside overtook me. I blew in tongues for 1 hour. I didn't know where I was. But when I started initially, I was aware of what was going on. And then the connection was made. Then after a few days, I came back to him and said, I need another hand. He said, why do you need another hand? He said, because the first fire has quenched. Because I felt different after that experience. But I woke up one morning feeling nothing. I said, the first fire has gone. I need you to start another fire. And he laughed. He said, ignorance is a disease. Sit down. I sat down. He said, after you receive it, it goes inside your belly and stays. Any other time you want it to function, the Bible says, out of your belly shall what? Flow. I said, so how do I make the thing flow? He said, how do you make a tap flow? He said, you turn the thing on the knob, then the water that is inside start coming out. So how do I turn this knob? You use a lot of technical terms. How do I turn it? He said, open your mouth and start again. So he said, look at me. He started speaking in tongues. I said, is it that easy? If you see what baby Christians are going through. I said, please, at least pray for me so I can start. He said, did you pray for me before I started? I looked at this guy. But I was sure because he's healing the sick. Things are happening. And I wanted to have what he has. So I said, okay, start again. I will join you this time. So he started talking in tongues. I said, are you sure I can do it? The guy said, just believe. Somebody who has received the Holy Spirit, using it is the problem again. I thought I need to be receiving it every time. So he said to me, when I start speaking in tongues, because you have already got it. So he started. I asked myself a question. I said, is this right? I thought it was the Holy Spirit that speaks whenever he wants. And why that thought was disturbing me, and I was still trying to answer the question before I could join. I don't know, the guy picked the thing. He said, the Holy Spirit told me something. I said, my. I said, let me hear what he told him. He said, you're asking yourself a question. Is this right? That I thought is the Holy Spirit that should be using the gift. And the guy turns and said, take this small Bible. He has one small pocket Bible. He said, take it. I took it. He said, open to John chapter 1 and read. I opened and read. He said, you can go home with the Bible. It's now your own. I said, but we have not finished with the Holy Spirit. He said, don't worry. We'll finish another time. Just go. I said, but I said, it's Holy Spirit thing. I'm not leaving today. He said, go. You understand. I will come and talk to you. I said, are you coming? He said, yes. So I started going. He said, but excuse me. Can you open to Revelation chapter 1? I turned to Revelation chapter 1. I said, what is it? Should I read? He said, no. See how you are using the gift anytime you want. The same way you have been given a gift and you are waiting for the man who gave you the gift to open whichever chapter. So if you go home with this Bible, you close it waiting for me to each time I come, I'm the only one who can open. No, it's now a free gift. You are permitted to use it. I said, the Holy Spirit talked to this guy. I must get this thing. I said, start again now. He said, I don't need to start. You start. And I opened my mouth. I said, Reba, Kere Shege, Leba Moseke. Since then till now, I have been speaking in other tongues. He has brought cripples out of the wheelchair. Blind eyes open. He has got deaf people hearing. Got dumb people talking. That same thing. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. The only two things you are permitted to pray for as a believer who already has the Holy Spirit. One is boldness. Acts chapter 4, you will see it. Two is utterance. Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 18, you see it. Pray for utterance. That you might have the ability to make known the mysteries of the gospel as you ought to. That's all. One time, the Bible now suggests you can also pray for wisdom, for understanding. It didn't say pray for power. Pastor, are you getting the tricks the enemy has used to paralyze soul winning in the church? People who should be going to deliver people, he has made them to know that they need deliverance. Why are people not winning souls? People who should have the power to go and help other people, he makes them know that they need power. So they are going about looking for power. Then what should unbelievers be looking for? And ministers are making it worse by using their own pulpit to help the devil in his work. And at the end of the day, the whole place is paralyzed. You teach evangelism, but these are innate problems that is preventing people. Because everybody that is sure he has something is excited about talking about it, about giving it out. Luke 21 verse 15. I will give you a mouth and wisdom which all your adversaries will not be able to contradict or resist. If you read the context, he was telling them about going in the Great Commission. There will be persecutions, there will be things, but he said, don't ever forget, it will not be you speaking at that time, it is the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. Then here he said, I will give you a mouth and a wisdom which your adversary will not be able to gainsay. The mouth is utterance, the wisdom is the well. See what the Holy Spirit gives you. A well with water, that is wisdom. On top of the well, he gives you a bucket with a rope. That is utterance. That bucket lowers inside the well and bring water and pour on people who are thirsty. He said the words of a man's mouth are like deep water. He said the words of wisdom is like a flowing brook, a flowing fountain. If you don't know, you'll be sitting at a fountain drinking fresh water. But the reason is because I have a bucket that can draw it. If I want to use today's technology to talk about it, I have a pumping machine that can actually pump the water. It's called utterance. No matter what you have heard, no matter what you know, no matter what you don't know, when you pray for utterance, what happens is that the Holy Spirit touches your tongue. That's why the prophet said, and he touched my mouth. It's utterance. It's anointing for speaking. A mouth that can convince no matter who you are. God said, I'll give you a mouth and a wisdom which your enemies will not be able to gainsay. Paul said in Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 18, he said, pray for me that I may be given utterance, that I may make bold the mysteries of the kingdom as I ought to. In other words, sometimes a minister rises to preach, you notice that the degree of utterance is not strong. The tap is flowing small. Another time you turn the same tap, is rushing. That's why the Bible says, pray that the pumping machine will be effective. Not that you don't have the power, but you need to have the ability to discharge it. Then he said, even though you are talking, you have utterance, a machine that pumps. Let the machine not be drawing from a dry well. Because if the well is dry, the machine will start pumping muddy waters out. That's when some people are talking, they are so anointed, but when you listen to them, you see your pastor talking like that, he talks bold, when you listen, you see holes. You go to your prayer, you say, Lord, please give him wisdom, increase his understanding of the scripture, increase his understanding of the things of God. Start praying for him for wisdom and say, let the utterance even grow stronger, then so that the well will have water. There was a man in the Bible, they say he was eloquent. His name was Apollos. The Bible says he mightily convinced the Jews. The thing was on his mouth, but he didn't understand well. What he was convincing them about is the baptism of John. So one husband and wife who had sat under Paul the apostle, Priscilla and Aquila, heard this guy preaching. They saw the potential of his message, that this guy has ability to convince people, but they saw that he doesn't have a balanced understanding. After he preached, they said, just come with us, come and eat, you have done a great job. That's the best way to do it. Give the man food first for the one he preached. Don't start by attacking, because you might wound somebody's confidence. Then when he's alive, he said, actually, you did a powerful job, but you know, there's just one or two things you missed out, and I want to help you so that let's when you speak among those who are matured, and they wonder what kind of, he said, what is it? He said, you know, we've been working with Paul. He has explained this thing well, that John the Baptist was only a medium. He was only a mediator. The baptism of John was just to prepare people for the coming of Christ. That right now it's not John's baptism that saves people. John was pointing to somebody. Don't stay at the signboard. Find where the signboard is pointing to so you can find the shop. He said, who John is pointing to is who I want to declare to you. And he explained to him about the death and resurrection of Christ, the substitution, and how that is the message. And that those who believe in it, they are now baptized in the name of Christ. The next time he grabbed a crowd. When you find such people in the church, take note of them. All you need to equip them with understanding of the message. But as far speaking, now the Bible said every one of you can also ask for utterance, fire in your mouth. God did not plan for us to convince people talking from our head, but instead of just every day saying utterance, one simple way is anytime you have to speak, say, Holy Spirit, I yield myself to you. I don't know how to talk to these people. Say it silently, because it's not when you bring your, you know, sometimes there are places you can't start talking like that. They wonder who you are talking to. But in a place like church, I can say, wonderful Holy Spirit, I bring it. Maybe in crusade, I can even say it. But sometimes you don't have to say it out loud. Say, Holy Spirit, you know without you, this thing will flop. If these people, I don't even understand their reason, their kind of, you know who they are, you know what they need, you know exactly what needs to be said to be able to get them. I give you my life. I give you my tongue. Take everything and reach. Then open your mouth and quote whatever scripture you have to start. Your job is to do the starting. The thing connects. And when it connects, after 30 minutes of speaking, of course, what you will discover somewhere, you will find yourself listening to yourself and wondering, where are these things coming from? Nobody perfects a ministry until he starts practicing. You will grow. You will make your mistakes. But you will learn the things of the Spirit. Amen. Ask God for a gift, a mouth, and a wisdom that no enemy will be able to gainsay. Ability to mightily convince people to believe in Jesus Christ. You can't listen to me and be normal. I don't speak for normal frequency. The thing will follow you. But I also know that as a human being, I don't have that ability. So I know where the thing is coming from. That's why I depend on the Holy Spirit. So I'm so helpless without his help. That's why I cry like I cry. Because if he doesn't come in, I'm so helpless. It is that dependence that brings his power into operation. When Holy Spirit is recognized and allowed, he will do what you cannot do. For it's not by power, it's not by might, it's by my Spirit, says the Lord. You need to be introduced to the guy behind this thing you are hearing. There is an invisible personality possessing the sense. Wonderful Holy Spirit. That is the real oracle of God. Learn to recognize him and his ministry. God is not depending on your talent or your beauty or your ability or your eloquence or your fine legs or your phonetics or your degree. No, he's dependent on the Holy Ghost. Father God depends on the Holy Ghost. Jesus Christ depends on the Holy Ghost. The church must learn to depend on the Holy Ghost. Without him, the Trinity cannot function. Without him, the church cannot perform. I reintroduce to you again the person of the Holy Spirit, the best friend you can have. The partner that will stand with you when every other person abandons you. The one that turns your failure into success. Do you know when I made mistakes and it's obvious, I go to the Holy Spirit, I say, please help me. The one that can turn anything around. Even when you didn't say it right, he will give the people the right interpretation. If you understand the Holy Spirit, you will become indefeatable. I reintroduce him to you again today. He's the one you need on this journey. He's the partner you need. You must learn to recognize him. You must learn to give him the respect and thank him after a job well done. You must learn to work in partnership with him. You must learn to depend on him. Then you are going to find abilities where you lacked it. You are going to find supernatural help where you lacked natural help. You are going to find assistance where you are without help. For if God be for us, who can be against us? Wonderful Holy Spirit. Reveal Jesus afresh to everyone here today. Reveal the Great Commission afresh to everyone's heart. Reveal yourself afresh to every one of us, Lord. You are the Lord of the harvest. Let there be multiplications in all the churches because we know your presence. Not because of our abilities, but because we know you, Lord. Grant us the help. Let there be multiplications everywhere. Let there be multiplications. The least among us to become 1,000. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise. I will look to another calling on any man. Holy Spirit, you are in all. Holy Spirit, you are in all.
Spirit, you are enough. I will look to another only, only man. Holy Spirit, you are. Spirit, you are in us. Holy Spirit, you are in us. I want to live to another only, on any man. Holy Spirit, you are in us. I will look to another only, of any man. Holy Spirit, you are. To another only, of any man. Holy Spirit, you are in us.
Thank you, Lord. A mouth and a wisdom which your enemy shall not be able to get said. A wisdom that cannot contradict, the Bible says. A wisdom that they cannot resist. The power of conviction. When a man has conviction in his heart, his words convicts other people who hear him. Moses went with a rod to Egypt and disarmed the army of Pharaoh with a rod. It was conviction that he was armed with.
You are the Lord, a holy. You deserve the glory, Jesus, your Lord. You're the Lord, holy. You're the Lord.
Your glory fill this house.
Been blessed by this message. For more of these and other inspiring messages by Pastor David Ogweli, please contact any Dominion City chapter all over the nation or Dominion City Lagos, 11/13 Jumat Olukoya, phone number 0179268790, 0803718 3623, 0803351 4993, or email ncftapes@yahoo.com. Still making eternal investment in your life.